Hey guys, what's up? It's me, Ebs, and today we're going to discuss what is bottleneck and one of the parts that makes bottleneck but stays under the radar. Well, first of all, let's talk about what is bottleneck. Bottleneck happens when any one or more of your computer parts hold back one or other parts of your computer to perform to their full potential. For example, if you put a GTX 980 or R9290 with the Pentium G3258, then the graphics card or the GPU will not be able to perform to its full potential. Here the processor is the reason of bottlenecking. It is holding back your graphics card to perform a lot slower than how it should perform or has the capability to perform. This is bottleneck. The bottleneck in your system could be your CPU, GPU, RAM, power supply and many other parts. So, you should always try to build a balanced system rather than maxing out in one of the parts. But the interesting hardware that I found yesterday bottlenecking my system or laptop was more than interesting. Many even don't think about it when considering bottlenecking. I game on my laptop, the HP ProBook 450 G1 with external graphics card. It is a 4th gen Core i5 with 8GB RAM and an AMD 8750M graphics card. The last few days I was playing Battlefield 4 on low settings and I usually get average 75fps when playing multiplayer. Then I saw certain dips in the frame rates to occasional 30s and my game starting to lag in large conquest maps. At first I thought my GPU wasn't capable of handling these large maps with 64 players. Then after a bit of research in the last few days I found out that there it was actually the HDD at 5400 RPM or hard drive as you may call it was actually the main reason of lag and fall of FPS. And the HDD was showing 99% uses and I was like OMG. To break it down, all its read and write capability was utilized in the game and still the system and the game needed more. So the HDD was not able to read these large maps as quickly as the CPU or GPU needs it to perform to their full potential. And guess what? If you have great CPU and decent GPU and your game is not performing as you expect it to perform or should perform, then it's your HDD making the bottleneck in your system. Don't get less than 7200 RPM HDD if you are making a medium to high-end build. Also, get a SSD if you have the budget. Because otherwise the HDD could be bottlenecking the system, stopping it to perform to its full potential. And for laptop users, the main reason because of your high-end laptop not performing to its full potential is usually the HDD. They're usually at 5400 RPM. Of course, you can upgrade to SSD or more RPM hard drives later on. Now hold on a second. Don't expect a rise in FPS in your games by just changing your HDD, because their job is to just read and write. They won't increase your gaming FPS, but decrease your load time in games, software and will perform faster. They will cancel the bottleneck and be able to read and write faster what the CPU and GPU needs, especially while putting up large open maps in game or launching a large software. So your games will not lose FPS occasionally like mine when rendering large open maps. They will not really hold down your CPU and GPU to perform at their full potential. So upgrading to SSD or a more RPM hard drive will stop those dips but not increase to how it should perform. Of course, things will load faster and boot time will be quick as well. And after a few Google searches, I also found that the bottleneck in many people's build is the HDD, as they upgraded all the parts except the ancient HDD they had previously. Hopefully I have cleared your concept about bottlenecks and also mentioned about one of the common bottlenecks that people don't bring into account. Always remember to make a balanced build to avoid bottlenecks or otherwise your system might perform slower than how it is supposed to perform. Don't forget to hit that like button if you like the video and also subscribe for future contents. If you have any questions, leave a comment below. Also like my Facebook page and join my Facebook group. Or you can follow me on Twitter, the links are in the description below, and hopefully I'll see you in my next video. Bye for now.